closing million dollar deals. Catch me swerving, burning $100 bills. How I feel when you falling, going places they never go. It ain't all about the money, but I stack it cause you.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another Madden 17 Ultimate Team gameplay. You can see the squad. We got Randall Cunningham. We got Ross in the number two position. Davis in the number one position. We got Corey Coleman. We got Braxton Miller. We got Jones right there. We got a triple tight end going on up there. We got James Brayton Ertz. We also got a pretty decent offensive line. On the defensive side, we ain't made too many changes, but we got everybody that we need in case the original people get burnt. I can make substitutions, you know, because we don't got no blockbusters on the squad. We still got the free cornerback. We got Deion Sanders boosted up as high as we can get him. We got Humphreys and we got Lattimore. And we got pretty good block shed. I think most of my people got 97 and higher block shed. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to read and react, how to keep the game flow fast-paced so you can get ready for Madden 18 when it comes out. Because in Madden 18, it's going to be better zones. It's going to be smarter AI. So it's a few things that you need to do on defense. The first thing you need to do is limit the money plays on first and second down. Once you get that established, you control the tempo of the game. So on this defense, which as soon as Madden 18 come out, I'm probably going to run this defense first. And that's the Bengals defense, the 3-3-5. So I got deep blues over the top, the safeties, and I got my corners playing zones. Because just in case Madden 18 still got broken zone coverage like Madden 17 did, I want to make sure that in the first series, as soon as my opponent get the ball, I lock down any out routes and any deep balls. That's the first thing that I want to establish. Now, if they throw underneath and all that type of stuff right here, you can see on 4th and 13, I just hold the swap button as soon as he makes his throw. As soon as he makes his throw, I hold the swap button. I don't want him to get no kind of crazy animation on 4th down, so I hold the swap button. I switch to him real fast, then let the computer do it, and we end up turnover on downs. Now, the thing that worries me is I wonder if Madden 18 is going to be just like Madden 17, where people in good field position like this guy was on 4th down, he should have punted me the ball. They need to make the game more realistic as far as sim style. They say it's on competitive style. I want to see if they make it more realistic as we come with the high point pass, which will be tailored in Madden 18. You won't be able to do the high point pass in Madden 18. It won't be as effective, which is a good thing because on this game, it wasn't no way for the defense to really react to it. In that high point pass situation, the guy was wide open. But sometimes you can throw over the linebacker here, and the linebacker don't even get a chance to play the ball, knock it down, tip it down, unless you got Mike Evans. My 6'5" Mike Evans, he snags a lot of them. But you can see my opponent, he's mixing it up pretty good, running a lot of hurry-up offense. So in Madden 18, I want to see if fatigue really plays. I didn't really pay attention. I think that's on sim style where injuries and fatigue comes into effect. But you can see my opponent hit me with a slant right there, so I am knowing that, go manually make my adjustments. I'm going to freeze the screen right here, and I am going to pick the tight end coming off the line right away. Hold him for 2 seconds to change his decision, and he has to chuck it up deep. He sees the tight end. He has his first read on the tight end again. I come cover that by myself. I don't make adjustments as playing hard flats or none of that kind of stuff, because then that makes two or three people open. I take his original read away after seeing what he likes to do, and then he holds the button down and throws it all the way down the field because the pressure is still coming out of my defense. Right here, we're going to flood the whole left side. I got everybody running to the left side, so he's trying to follow me with the user, and I'm expecting for me to have two blockers in front of me. But on Madden 17, you ain't gonna get too many downfield blockers. On Madden 18, you will be able to. So that's how I like to set up my offense. I like to come out, throw it short a couple times to set up the deep whammy.
Expose him! Expose him!
Let's go! Hit that thumbs up button for your boy, man. If you're not a hater, if you're a hater, just continue watching the video. I appreciate all the love and support. But you can see my opponent is coming with a screen right there, and we made the right read. Should have been able to jump it. I waited probably too long and then got caught behind his blocker, but I had the right mindset, man. So right here, I'm still limiting anything deep. You haven't seen him throw but one deep ball past 15 yards, and it came down to a pick. So that's letting you know I'm keeping everybody deep. No reason. I got the lead. No reason to give up no EA flukes. It is made by EA, so that's something that you got to always keep in the back of your head. Don't be too aggressive sending 7 and 8 people. You know what I mean? And right here, I told Deion to swat the ball. But Deion got a mind of his own. He's not in the starting position. I put him in because he got more speed than the original person and awareness when my opponent chucks it deep. And when he does chuck it deep, once again, he comes down with a pick. I take away all his short reads. For some reason, he don't want to run the ball because I came out in the 4-6, and it looks like I was getting a lot of pressure to him. And right here, I knew that he was in man coverage because, once again, if you move a guy out and they follow you right away, even if you move him to the other side of the field, if somebody follows you to the other side of the field, it's man coverage. So once I seen that, I knew it was man coverage. I put him on a slant across the other side of the field, and I did my thug thizzle. Right here, I buy myself a little bit of time and throw a laser beam down the field to LeSean McCoy, and he picks up about 35 yards. Now we on the 7-yard line. It's time to put a dagger in him, man. So if y'all ready for Madden 18, tell me what y'all most excited about. Tell me what y'all ready for. Right here, we motion the guy, making it look like we doing a route, going to the opposite side, and we just pitch it. He haven't seen it all day. That's how you mix your offense up. That's how you mix your defense up. It's all love. Let's go.